Hello everyone, Fresh Eggs here, and welcome back to another episode on Coldobrough Park Farm. And we've been busy all day. We started very early this morning. We've managed to plant radish into fields 7, 8, 9 and 2. Planting of sowing is going to start in field 8, and that's going to be soybeans. Got cracked on with that, did that about what, 1:30, finished that by about 1:30, started at what, 5 o'clock this morning, 5:30, managed to get all that done. So I've come down, thought right, let's cut field 22, got the case out, the Puma, you know, the 185, the biggest tractor we've got on the farm, and get the mowers connected up to it, took it to field 22. And well, obviously I forgot about moving the trailer. That's why I've got the case fired up now. I'm going to move this trailer, and came onto the field, lowered the mowers, and the PTO just gave in, and so we've got this replacement John Deere 7530. Which came on a low loader about 30 minutes ago, and they've taken the Puma away and came up with all kinds of lights on the dash. So yeah, something's amiss, and it started, the guy who came to pick it up saw a leak of fluid, so I don't know what's going on, to be honest with you. All kinds of stuff. The drive itself, the tractor itself was driving fine, the gearbox, but the front loader wouldn't work, the hydraulics for the front loader, the PTOs wouldn't work, so something's gone wrong with it. So yeah, I don't know. No idea. So we've got this replacement 7530, which, you know, it's not as powerful, I don't think, as the... In fact, it's not as powerful as the 185. So... And it's turned out to be an overcast, boring, cloudy, dull, grey day as well. So it's, apart from this morning, cracking on and getting some results done in the fields, just planting radish, it's turned out to be a pretty crap day, really. So yeah, it's cost us £2,000 to have a replacement. That's not free of charge, guys. And then obviously we've got the cost of repairing the case on top. We've got to cover, so there's that as well. So we're going to get the mowers hooked up to the John Deere. Oops, thought I could judge that then, but obviously not. Let's leave this here. Going to get this hooked up to the rower afterwards. Okay. So yeah, it's turned out to be a really dull day, guys. The mowers. Let's get the mowers back out and put them away. Should have left them out, really. Right. So this is 210 horsepower, whereas the Puma of ours is 225. So it's a little bit lower on horsepower. It's got a front loader attachment, which is good, because the case did come with a front loader attachment. Yeah, so we can still use that in case, so hopefully it's not in there long. So let's hook up the... on the front now. 7530. I mean, obviously, you guys know I'm not a, you know, I'm not a John Deere person. I don't mind them. I mean, they're in my top three, but I prefer not to use them. You know. So. Let's see if we can connect up to that. It's caught, isn't it? Yeah, it's caught. There we go. got caught on the right. Looks pretty swish inside, really. So this is exactly what I was doing before, and I lowered the mowers. Switched them on, and then he just went pew and just died. Just the whole spin and crackling and funny noise of the PTO and everything. I'm like, oh god, what's happened? So, yeah. So let's try again, shall we? Bit afraid to turn it on now. At least we know the what you call it, the actual mowers are alright. So yeah, no idea what it's going to cost us. First time I've ever had a PTO go bust. Made an awful sound. All lights came up on dash and were awful. So I rang them up. I said, right, yeah, we'll be there soon. I thought, right, okay, so cracked on. Within 40 minutes, turned up with the replacement. This is basically something, this is the closest I had to match to the case. So I can't really complain. It's cost us £2,000, this guy's, for a replacement tractor. I did consider just not having a replacement tractor whilst our Puma was away. But we need to get this field cut, and this is the only tractor. Saying that, I mean, we could just put the back mower, the side mower, on one of the 1455s. That wouldn't have been a problem, but, you know, we use this for other stuff as well. So we need to get this cut. We'll get this cut, guys, and get it rode. So yeah, as you probably tell, guys, I'm a bit peed off with that, with the case going bust. But what can you do? You know, it's one of those things. A lot of machinery work goes faulty and broken, and you name it, on farms. All the time. It's like it's our turn. And maybe it's time for me to maybe have a look at John Deere's. I mean, this is a 7530, it's an oldest tractor. I am in the market for another tractor for up at the pig farm, and when we start extending in the pig farm, we're not going to raise them for the flat bit. But yeah, that's John Deere's is, I mean, obviously you guys know it's Massey Ferguson, Fendt, and then John Deere. They're my top three brands. So I don't mind John Deere at all. We did swap out John Deere's to Fendt though on Thornton when we were managing that farm. Whole lot, everything branded John Deere went, and we replaced it all with Fendt tractors and equipment mostly. So yeah, a John Deere 7530. right, we'll get this cut and get it road. We've managed to plant, like I've said, radish, and I need to check the condition of the poplars, see what fertilisation growth they need. In fact, you know what, I'm going to try and check that now, because I just got a feeling. Okay, it looks like it's still growing, and it's still on. That might be ready now, guys, for the next fertilisation. Maybe. Could be. Why is it only show? What about field 2 and 7 and 8? They're fertilised, they've got poplars in. Anyhow. Let's get poplars in field 5. What about to do? Very, very misty, dull day today. Got sun later. If we get this road, get it in the clamp. Too far gone then. Right, go on, make a start on it. Yeah, like I said, guys, been gutted. The case has given up the ghost. And you know, it's 225 horsepower. This is 210, 209. So, you know, that's another disappointment. It's not as what's the word I'm looking for, as powerful, but I don't think we'll notice it really. It's pulling the mowers fine, just like the case did. So, it's just a cost at the moment. I just feel like we're not winning with the farm. I mean, we've got stuff kind of in check, I guess you could say. I mean, look, we've got the sheep, we've got the cow pasture. You know, that there seem to be, you know, under control. Their productivity is 199%. Cleanliness is down to 75, 78. So once this is road, we'll clean those out. But we've got nothing planted apart from radish, you know, for fertilisation and poplars. We've got 86,000 in the bank. So yeah, it's just feel like I'm not making no progress. We've got nothing in the clamp. We've got silage bales, hay bales, straw bales. I guess it's not, you know, when I think about it, so I guess it's not too much. Worse. Oh well. It's 4:45 in the afternoon. I don't know where today's going, to be honest with you. I get this cut and road and picked up before the day's over. And the sun, or at least the clouds, the grey clouds are starting to dissipate. John Deere before, but don't mind John Deere, but alright. said, yeah, just give me what cap. He said, you know, what tractor do you want? I said, well, something with same caliber as, you know, the case, like horsepower and front loader. Right, okay. And then I says, are you not fussy? He says, no, I just want a replacement tractor. I can't go without the tractor. And here we are, John Deere 7530. If it had been in New Holland, I'd have told them to take it back. Maybe. I just saw a vision as that wanted to get this cut. I want to get this cut by the end of today after planting radishes, you see. This needs ploughing. So we might get the front weight on and the plough on it as well, start ploughing this field. Nearly finished cutting. Guess, you know, tractor equipment breaks and everybody, it's not just me, you know. Sartre, like I said, it's... I think you've got to deal with. Fairly new tractor is that, you know, the Case Puma. It's our biggest tractor, it's like our... Well, you know, it's our biggest tractor, it's the one we depend on the most, really. Like the 1455s, they help out a lot, but one's older than the other one. It's amazing, you know, when something breaks, how much you take it for granted on the farm. Imagine if the mowers went now. You know. So. Might start looking for a back cottager butterfly mower. Get rid of the side mower. Speed things up a little bit. And maybe that's something in the future. Also, we need a bigger seeder, bigger cultivator. So there's a lot of stuff we need to be doing. Root crops is something which is in the pipeline, and I'm helping out a neighbouring farmer at the moment with a field. So we make a bit of money on that, and the price of the field comes down. Along now. Another 5 minutes of this, guys, then we'll get the rower out. Was going to make grass bales. But the next couple of cuts of this grass now, after this has been ploughed, is for the clamp. As well with the maize which is going in, so we're going to see if we can make a good start on the maize. The chaff, give it a kick start with a couple of cuts of the field 22, they don't like to use grass bales, I mean, or as many. I mean, this will produce quite a few grass bales, but maybe field 23 is better for grass bales, because, you know, grass, it dries out, turns into hay or goes mouldy. It's not, you can't keep grass bales for that long at all. Can't keep any kind of bale for that long, really. Sandwich bales, obviously, you can keep them for the longest, but straw bales last a while. I mean, hopefully now we've got the productivity up on the upside to keep the cows and the sheep clean. We can definitely see a difference in profit on the milk over the midnight turn. See what we get. I mean, we came out at 1,500 something. Call it £1,600. And that was with productivity being down to, I think we were down to 27% or something like that on the cows. Now we're at 99%. So again, we'll have to see. See how much money we get. Because it's not covering the cost of running costs of the vehicles, the loan, the leasing fees. It's not covering any of that. It's paying some of it off, because it's £1,600 into profit, but our outgoings are about £5,000-£6,000. But we have actually sold a lot of equipment as well and returned a lot of stuff. So we got rid of the manure trailer, you know. So I'll see what the figures are tonight and then let you know in the next episode. And hopefully the outgoings are as much and the income is a lot better. The milk, and that's a positive thing, and I might feel that we're starting to turn over and win on the farm then, maybe. At the moment though, it just seems too much is up and going, and not making any progress with the fields, and equipment dying on us. It's starting to have a toll on us, I've got to admit. I nearly finished this field. I've cut it. As well to roll out the clamp and flatten it down. Right guys, I'm going to get the rower on, we'll go around the headlands. park this up here. And we'll get the 1455, get that fired up. Brought the small trailer down here as well. Notice we don't have a trailer down here, so we brought that up from down from Coldobrough farm to Chantry after we sold the remaining barley. Got 8,500 for it. I hope this powers it. I hope it's enough. I think this is 180 now, this tractor. The other 1455 is only 150. Okay. It's a big merger, is that? To the right, that's correct. Lower turn up. So it powers it alright. It's not a problem. We'll go around the headlands, guys. We'll do the entire field. It's turned out to be a nice evening at least. It's now coming up 6 o'clock. I'll get this done before 7, all being well. A couple of runs with the forage wagon to the clamp, and this will be in the clamp then, and then we'll call it a day. I think clean up the cows and sheep, call it a day. Definitely. Right guys, we're going to call it there for this episode, so thanks for watching. You know, daily life on the farm of Coldobrough Farm with me, Fresh Eggs. Hope you're enjoying all the episodes so far, or the Let's Play series so far in general, and leave your comments below on your thoughts. Until then, bye for now.